Gentleman from the Northern Mariana Islands, Mr. Sablon, is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I yield myself as much time as I make.
Without objection.
Mr. Speaker, I rise in support of H.R. 3178, the Strengthening Transparency in Higher Education Act, and I want to thank the gentleman from Indiana for joining me today in managing the bill. I want to thank Ms. Fox, Chair of the Subcommittee on Higher Education and Workforce Training, for her hard work on this bill. I also want to thank our Chairman, John Klein, and Ranking Member Bobby Scott also for their leadership. No matter which side of the aisle we're on, we can all agree that by helping people get an education, we're benefiting both the individual and the American economy. And in today's world, getting an education means more than grade school and high school. It means higher education as well. H.R. 3178 will help more Americans get a college education. And it does so by helping college students and potential college students and their families get more of the information they need to make the tough financial decisions that go along with a college education. With more than 7,000 colleges and universities nationwide to choose from, the college application process can be quiet, overwhelming for students and their families. H.R. 3178 helps to bridge the information gap by creating a new online tool for students and families called the College Dashboard, to be managed by the U.S. Department of Education. This website will replace the cumbersome College Navigator and compile information submitted by institutions on enrollment, graduation rates, cost, financial aid, and faculty status. The bill will also streamline existing efforts at the federal level to reduce confusion and require better coordination by federal agencies to avoid duplication. A bill like H.R. 3178 is particularly important for students in America who come from areas like the one I represent, the Northern Mariana Islands, that are geographically remote. Students from my district cannot hop in the car with their parents and drive around the country looking at colleges. It costs thousands of dollars to fly off island, as we say. And for families who come from some of the poor areas of our nation, like the one I represent, those thousands of dollars that would be spent to look at colleges would be better spent paying tuition, buying books, or covering the cost of room and board. Having more information readily available about the cost of any particular college and the return on investment that graduates of that college can expect is also critically important for students and families who often are investing in a college education for the first time. Making an investment like that for families that have never sent anyone to college is a leap of faith, a huge risk, and if we can help reduce the risk or give those families a better sense of the value of the financial sacrifices they will have to make to pay for college, then we should do so. By supplying key information about the colleges online on the College Dashboard, as this measure does, we would help bridge the geographic and socioeconomic gaps that can be a barrier for bright, hardworking, and ambitious students everywhere in America to get a college degree. And when we can do that, we're helping these individuals have a more productive and satisfying life. And we are helping our nation remain productive and competitive in our world economy. Again, I want to thank Chairwoman Fox for the opportunity to work with her on this important and meaningful legislation. I urge my colleagues to support H.1-3178, the Strengthening Transparency in Higher Education Act. And I reserve the balance of my time.
The gentleman reserves. The gentleman from Indiana.
I want to thank again the gentleman from Northern Mariana Islands for his leadership on this issue. We have no further speakers. Is the gentleman prepared to close?
Mr. Speaker, I have no further speakers, and I yield back the balance of my time.
The gentleman from the Northern Mariana Islands reserves yields back the remainder of his time. The gentleman from Indiana.
Mr. Speaker, I yield myself the remainder of my time.
The gentleman is recognized.
Mr. Speaker, in closing, I want to again thank the gentleman from the Northern Mariana Islands for his leadership on this important bill and all my colleagues on both sides of the aisle for their hard work on this bipartisan legislation. Going through the college decision application process should be an experience students look forward to. as they plan the next stage of their lives. The Strengthening Transparency in Higher Education Act makes the reforms necessary to ensure the information available to students is more accessible, relevant, and helpful as they go through that process. I'm pleased with the good work we've been able to do here on Capitol Hill. I want to thank Chairwoman Fox for her leadership on this bill as well. And I urge my colleagues to support the legislation and yield back the balance of my time. The gentleman-